Mayer's your brother. How's he enjoying the prospect of playing six parts?
Actually, he doesn't know about it yet. If he did, he never would have agreed.
Fraser, you told me you were going to messenger the script to me this morning.
I'm so sorry. I was tinkering with it until the very last minute. But not to worry, your natural talent will carry you through. All right,
I don't even know who I'm playing.
Don't worry, Niles. I'll just cue you as we go along.
Well, shouldn't I at least prepare a little?
No, now listen. Your natural spontaneity is your best asset as an actor. What was it the Yale Daily News said about your Tartuffe?
Oh, who remembers? But I had the magnetism of Marlon Brando, the charm of Danny Kaye, and the range of Laurence Olivier.
The door was answered by Miss Carlotta Thorndyke. Her face was unfamiliar, and when she opened her lips, I caught a hint of some exotic accent.
In fact, ow! Thank God you called.
This is a grisly business, Miss Thorndyke.
I can't believe any of my guests could be a mobbable murderer.
That's easy for you to say.
Inspector, I was strolling in the garden when this dreadful tragedy occurred.
Did anyone see you?
Several people. Hans, the German butler.
Bjorn, I saw the gentleman.
O'Toole, the gardener.
Aye, it was himself, for no mistake.
As well as Prudence McAllister.
Yes, I was taking a breath of air.
I tried to shake Nigel's alibi, but each witness was adamant. O'Toole.
Faith, and it's true.
Hans.
Jawohl.
Miss McAllister.
Oh, busy, yes.
There remained one suspect whose whereabouts had not yet been established. Pippo the Dwarf, a retired circus performer. Exactly. Where were you when the murders occurred, Pippo? Pippo, where were you?
I was at the movies.
Different roles and six different accents. I've half a mind to walk right out of here.
Yes, I'm sorry, Niles, but you're doing brilliantly.
Oh, except your Hans could be a
bit gruffer.
Don't direct me.
I'm sorry. You're right. Right now, frankly, I'm just a bit more worried about being over time.
Go. This is turning into a bloodbath.
See, that's why I prefer TV. You want to be able to see that stuff.
By this time, I was more baffled than ever, so I played a hunch. Hans, may I see your fingernails?
Why?
They seem a bit ragged for a butler.
All right. I'm not what I appear. None of us is. I'm not a butler. I'm not even German.
Sit down, Inspector. You're about to hear a fascinating tale. Each of us holds a piece of the puzzle to relate to you. When we've finished, you'll know the full dark secret of Nightmare Inn.
Are you through with it, Hans?
Be quiet, Mother. Mother and I moved here when I was a small boy after the tragic death of my father. I kept the pain of that loss buried deep within me like a serpent coiled within a damp cave. Okay, that's it. Never mind all that. I'm just going to take this gun off the table. Sorry about that, O'Toole. I guess we'll never hear your fascinating piece of the puzzle. Or yours, Cragen and Peppo. For the McAllister sisters stand back to back, I'm short on bullets. Thank you. What was your name again, dear?
Miss Thorndyke.
Thank you. And also Mr. Wing. And of course, one final bullet for myself, so the mystery will die with me.